on this subject. So now I can start the introductions on microcontroller. From the knowledge of our last classes on microprocessors, so we are familiar about the architecture, internal architecture of any microprocessor, which consists of a CPU, general purpose registers, instruction decoder, program counter, stack pointer, and some timing and control timing and control unit. So these are the general functional blocks inside any architecture of a microprocessor. So a microprocessor cannot work without any other subsystems like memory and IO devices. So to build the minimum microprocessor based system, we need a CPU, a microprocessor, and minimum amount of the memory. The volume of the memory must be limited within the address range or address space of any microprocessor. The same for the IO system, that is input output system. In addition to that, we can connect or add different peripherals like A2D, D2A, timers, interrupt controller, and many more. So microprocessor based systems requires the integration of all these blocks, that is microprocessors, IOs, memories, and peripheral devices. And we know there is a concept of address space for a microprocessor. Now the address space, by address space means we divide the memory address space and the IO address space. For example, in case of 8085, the size of the address space is about 64 kilobytes. That means each unique location, address location, can hold one unit of the byte of information. So the specification of the, one of the major specification of the microprocessor is how many bytes, how many bits, as well as the what is the clock speed or clock rate. So these are the two fundamental specifications of any microprocessor. But now we are going to study the theory of the microcontroller. In microcontroller, so these are the general diagram of any microprocessor. That means the memories and the IOs are to be connected with a different bus, address data bus, and the control bus, and more peripherals could be added in case of a microprocessor. So this is the general diagram of any microprocessor. But microcontroller includes all these subsystems into a single package. So microcontroller, by definition, is a single chip VLSI unit, also called the microcomputer, which, although having a limited computational capabilities and possesses enhanced input-output capability and a number of on-chip functional units. So these are, whenever these units are externally connected in case of a microprocessor, this becomes off-chip. But in case of a microcontroller, these are within the chip or a single package. That's why it is called the on-chip functional unit. So that is the general behavior of the microprocessor. So this is the difference of the microcontroller between the microcontroller and the microprocessor. The microprocessors are multitasking in nature, can perform multiple tasks at a time, but not for all microprocessors. That means in case of a 8085, it can only perform the single task, that is single program. But in case of a microcontroller, a single task oriented, for example, an application of washing machine designed for a designed for washing cloths only. So this is the application. So if we refer the different functional units, so in case of microprocessor, the RAM, ROM, IO ports, and the timers can be added externally and can vary in number. That depends on the interfacing capability of any microprocessor. That is, how many address lines are available, how many data lines are available, etc. In case of a microcontroller, as because these units are embedded inside a single package, so these components are to be embedded together on a chip and are fixed in number. So there is no expansion. There is no possibility to expand on the volume of these units. But in case of a microprocessor, it is possible to add a RAM, ROM of different sizes as well as the I/O ports. So these are major differences. So definitely, as because each functional units are embedded in a single package, so the reliability of operations for a microcontroller is much more than a microprocessor, because there is a chance of noise interruptions over the buses like address data and the control lines. That depends on how the interconnections are done to integrate, to connect the external units for a given microprocessor. So there is a chance, that means, because a microprocessor cannot work without a minimum program. That program is a fixed program which resides in a ROM, that is read-only memory. So sometimes the fixed program is called the basic input-output programs for a microprocessor. So that's why the microprocessor, when it is powered up, it must execute the basic input-output program for activating its different capability, like self-diagnostic process and many more. But in case of a microcontroller, the same programs are stored inside the not ROM, data RAM, program memory. So we will discuss for a given microprocessor architecture when we will be starting the given microcontroller architecture. So these are the basic difference between the microprocessor and the microcontroller. And we have a quick functional property between the microcontroller and the microcontroller working. So this is the definition, that is definition what the component functionalities a microcontroller include. These are listed. At least all microcontroller must include these functional elements or functional unit. 8 or 16 bit, even higher bit, that means that depends on the capability of the microprocessor, whether it is 8 bit. In case of a microprocessor studies, the same things have been referred. For example, 8085 is an 8-bit microprocessor. Why? Because it has an internal 8-bit data bus. So the width of the data bus specifies the processing speed of a microcontroller. That is, whether it is 8-bit and 16-bit. As for example, a big number can be expressed in terms of the 16-bit or multiple 16 bits. But whenever we refer this big number or operand, so more number of the units, bytes are required in case of 8-bit. So as the operands will be processed sequentially, so definitely the computation time for a 8-bit microprocessor would be higher or larger than that in case of a 16-bit microprocessor. Also, for a 32-bit microprocessor or 64-bit microprocessor, the speed is much high. As for example, a microprocessor which are used for a 64-bit functional capability, that means data width. What is that now? What is the name? That is a Pentium processor. So Pentium processor follows this architecture, which whose data bus is about 64 bit. In case of a microcontroller, also the 64 bit data bus are available for a high end applications. But in general, for industrial application, 8 or 16 bit microcontrollers are generally used. So that's why a microcontroller must include 8 bit or 16 bit microprocessors. How the microcontroller works? According to the functional unit, the microcontroller chip is a high speed device, but as compared with a computer, it is slow. Thus, each instruction will be executed within the microcontroller at a quick speed. Once the supply is turned on with the help of the quartz crystal, the clock rate, it will get the clock rate or clock timing signal, and the microprocessor, the microprocessor inside the microcontroller starts executing. So these are same for how the microcontroller works. That is that this is identical to that in case of a microprocessor. So basic microcontroller types, that means the nature of the CPU, how in respect of the addressing, the memory addressing, as well as the how it can address the data. So that is extensively or exhaustive in nature, which depends on the types of the microcontroller. So for example, the microcontroller in generally classified according to the part number. For example, the first 8-bit microcontroller has been introduced by Intel Corporation in 1978 or something like that, 8051. And the standard is called the MCS51 standard. So MCS51 standard specifies the architecture of the 8051. There are a series of the chip. The number is given here, 89S5152, etc. So the MCS51 standard has been introduced by the Intel Corporation, which is the first kind of the 8-bit microcontroller. This is the 8-bit microcontroller. Later on, the Advent Corporations basically has manufactured the MCS51 standard microcontroller. Their part name is 8980. 80 stands for Atmel, anyway, the company part name. Also, nowadays, the types of the microcontroller, the power of the microcontroller has been enhanced by the Atmel Corporation with AVR type. Now, what is the abbreviation of the AVR? That is Advanced Virtual RISC Processor. As the name, what is RISC and what is SIGS? You need to learn. So, what is virtual RISC? What is physical RISC? Anyway, so AVR stands for the Advanced Virtual RISC type processor a microcontroller contains in case of AVR architecture. There is a difference between the 8051 and the AVR architecture. The same, that means manufactured by Atmel Corporation. The AVR microcontroller, their part name starts with Atmega. Atmega 8, Atmega 16, the last number indicates the width of the data bus, whether it is 8-bit data bus, whatever, and 16-bit like that, or 32. So these are the nomenclature of the AVR microcontroller. Another company, Microchip Technology, their microcontroller name starts with a part name PIC, Peripheral Interconnect Controller, PIC. So their microcontroller name is PIC. So there are varieties of the microcontroller which are manufactured generally by the leading company of international repute, like Intel Corporation, Atmel Corporation, Microchip Technology, NEC Japan, National Electric Company Japan, Siemens Incorporation, Philips. So these are the reputed vendor, reputed manufacturer who has implemented the standard architecture of MCS standard, AVR standard, etc. Also, they have a dedicated microcontroller, which case it is called the ASIC, Application Specific Integrated Circuit, Anyway, so this is the ASIC technologies are very much used for embedded systems application. That is different. Similarly, the Motorola has their own microcontroller like MC68 series H. Dialog Incorporation has their own series Z80 is a microprocessor, their own name. So these are the So these are the special features of any microcontroller. The microcontroller size according to the memory device. The memory device is divided into the two types. They are embedded memory microcontroller, they are external memory. What is the difference between the embedded memory? That means the generally the microcontroller includes the embedded memory, embedded RAM, embedded ROM, etc. But there is also a feature, the microcontroller, given microcontroller can also access the, and this is generally the SRAM type, like static RAM type, which are generally used for the microprocessor, like 8085, Z80, etc. That is, both the features are available. It can, a microcontroller can access or can access the instruction data from its internal memory, program memory, and this is called the embedded memory. And the definition is like that. Now, there is a very important concept of microprocessor, microcontroller instruction. So there are different types of the instruction nature or set which has been developed by the microcontroller manufacturer. There are broadly the two types of the instruction. One is called the CISC, complex instruction set computer. It allows the programmer to use one instruction in place of many simpler program. For example, we have studied that when studying the nature of instruction in case of 8085, the instruction can be classified according to the size, whether it is a 3-byte, 2-byte, as well as the type of the addressing or mode of the addressing. But for given example, as a given example, that is move immediate instruction, which is MBI, the operation code or opcode, which operates on the different types of operand, and for each types of the, that is MBI B, MBI A, there is a different operation code, single byte, followed by operand, because MBI instruction requires the additional operand. But in case of a 6-byte instruction, it is not like that. So the move or move immediate, these are merged to form a one operation code. So depending on the nature of the another field, the operation code will work in a different manner. That means the lesser number of the instructions are available in case of a 6-type instruction. But in case of a 8085, we have seen there are 274 or 275 types of the instruction, depending on the total according to the data sheet. But in case of a microcontroller, very fewer instructions are available, because if it follows the six type instruction set, complex instruction set. So there is another instruction set, reduced instruction set computer. In this type, the sets reduces the design of the microprocessor for any industrial application. It allows each instruction to operate on any register or any addressing mode and simultaneous access of the program and the data. Simultaneous access on the program and the data, which is not possible by a given microprocessor. But microcontroller, it has this kind of power. That means parallelly it can access the program and the data. Not like that, it will fetch the operation code, opcode fetch cycles in respect of the baud cycle, then the multiple number of the memory read cycles or the memory read write cycles, or IO read cycles and the IO write cycles are required. So the number of the machine cycles is also reduced in case of a RISC type instruction. So these are the advanced features of microcontroller instruction. We will study. It is a basically the subject under computer. That means architecture. So this is the example of the six and example of the RISC type instruction. Here we see that means it is a complex instruction set computer. AX is a general purpose register of 16 bit. Anyway, so ultimately RISC type instruction, it is somewhat similar. So power cannot be analyzed, but there are some other type of instruction. Whenever we will study the programming, then it will be clear, much more clear. But right now you must remember that means that there are two types of the instruction set, RISC and the SIG for a microcontroller. Another important feature of the microcontroller is type of the internal bus. What is that? The type of the internal bus, that means generally this is a address space of a memory or memory space. Some part of the memory space are partitioned into the variable RAM, program ROM, that means within ROM, as well as the stack memory. And there is a unique set of the data address and the control bus, which are coming from the timing and the control unit of the memory unit, and this is the processor. That means one set of buses are available. Now, what is the advantage and the disadvantage? Advantage is that it does not segregate or distinguish between the data memory and the program memory, because memory space is unique with respect to the program as well as the data. And in this case, the processor executes the instruction from the bottommost address location. That means it starts executing from 00 in to maximum address space. This type of simplest architecture of the bus is called the von Neumann architecture. The von Neumann architecture is followed in case of a 8-bit microprocessor architecture. So in this architecture, one data path or one bus exists for both the instruction as well as the data. So it is slower. That's why it is slower. The von Neumann architecture is slower. So microprocessor is slower, but in case of another type of architecture whose name is Harvard or Princeton architecture, in that case, there is a two sets of the buses. One sets are dedicated or associated with the program memory or program ROM, so address data and the control. Another set is also provided with another memory, register set or data memory. So that's why it has a capability, that means it can access the code and the data simultaneously over the two buses. It will not overlap with respect to its operation. So that is the speciality of the von Neumann architecture. And this type of architecture results in the increase in the processing speed. So microcontroller follows, generally the microcontroller follows, every microcontroller follows the Harvard architecture. This type of architecture, that means it has a two sets of the address and the data bus dedicated to the program, and dedicated to the program memory as well as dedicated to the data memory. Another thing is that there is no registers, unlike in the case of 8085. So 8085 has a six number of the registers. This can be used as a byte of registers or in pairs, that is 16 bit. So register resides in the internal architecture. It is also a storage, temporary storage or general purpose storage area. But in case of a microcontroller, there is no such registers at all. Rather than it has a data memory space, some part of the data memory space are working as a set of registers. That is the specialty. We will discuss in details about the when we study the 8085 architecture particularly. So the comparison can be presented between the two architectures, two bus architecture, that is von Neumann and the Harvard architecture, as well as the two types of the instruction, CISC or the RISC. So when studying the microprocessor, you must be thoroughly familiar about the types of the interfacing bus, as well as the nature of the instruction, types of the instruction. So this is a basic prerequisite for studying the microprocessor or microcontroller. Now, most of we'll study the MCS51 microcontroller as well as AVR microcontroller after them. So these are standard textbook or book for this 8051 microcontroller ebook by Majidi and Majidi. So this is the original books is in different format, but these are digital books, so its format is different. These books is available whenever we start studying the architecture of the a particular microcontroller 8051, this will be helpful. So this is the internal architecture of MCS51 or 8051 microcontroller. The basic blocks are shown. On-chip program memory or on-chip ROM for storing the program code. There is a CPU, MCS51 CPU. On-chip RAM is there, which is called the data RAM. As well as this amount of the RAM is used for as a general purpose register or set of registers. On chip timer, there are two timers. That is a peripheral, important peripheral. This is called the timer and the control input. This elementary block can be programmed as a timer as well as the counter. So what is the property of the timer and the counter is not be understood very much. We'll discuss in detail in general principle of the timer and the counter. And it includes the three ports, or in fact four ports. The ports, all ports are of 8-bit length. So this is a bus, which can be used as an input and output ports. So the I/O ports are grouped into four groups. One is called the P0 group. Another second one is a P1, then P2, and the P3. So consisting of all the four groups of the I/O ports, it has a 8 into 4, 32 lines. So the 32 lines are coming out. That means the I/O devices are much more enhanced. Each single lines of the I/O ports can be programmed individually. That is another facility. So that means 32 I/O lines can be connected interface with the external devices. These single port lines can be used as well as the, it can be used as a, in a group, that is 8-bit port lines. It has a serial data communication interface line, that is called the serial port, which are the two lines. One is called the TXD, another is called the RXD. So it is powered up by generally the 24 megahertz or runs. And 8085 microprocessor runs with a clock rate of how much? 6.144 megahertz. But the operating clock frequency is divided by 2. That is, divided by 2 means 3.044. So it is much lesser than that. That means the oscillator speed is about 24 megahertz, even higher than that, 48 megahertz. So that's why a microcontroller, it is possible that every microcontroller has a very high clock rate or high clock speed. Rather than for any given microprocessor. Also, it has a facility that means these port lines can also be interfaced to the external memory if required to enhance the memory size or internal memory size. We'll discuss when we study the definite amount of the particular interfacing diagram. And MCS 51 standard chip, microcontroller chip 8051, 52, or 8031, three types of the chip initially formed. The volume of this internal unit as shown here. That means size of the ROM on chip program memory is only 4K. It is lesser, not the 64K. In case of 8052, it is double 8K. In case of 8031, it has no program memory. That is the disadvantage. It has a data byte, 8051 has a data byte, very small, 128 bytes only. 128 bytes. But in case of 8052, it is 256 bytes. Again, it must be remembered that means it is not a free data RAM which is available to user or programmer. Part of the data RAM are used for storing the information to the general purpose register or set of the registers. We'll discuss. It has a two timer, timer 0 and the timer 1, but in case of 8052, it has a three timer, timer 0, 1, 2. It has a number of I/O lines are same, 32. It has a one serial data interface, communication interface, which is called the UART, Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter. It has an interrupt sources, on-chip interrupt sources. So we did not study, we have studied the different types of the interrupt, that is general interrupt and the vector interrupt. In case of 8085, what are the vector interrupt? RST 7.5, 5.5, 6.5, trap. It is also, the 8085 is also process the external interrupt request, that is what the INTR. So these are, we have some knowledge of the how the interrupt should be processed. But it has a, 8051 has a six types of the interrupt sources, two of which are the physical or hardware interrupt, that is INTR1 and the INTR0. The fours are internal interrupt, that is like vector interrupt. 8052 has an eight number of the interrupt resources. So these are the comparisons of between the MCS 51 microcontroller in respect of the program memory, data memory, and the peripheral, that is timer, IOs, serial interface, and the sources of the interrupt. So these are the basic things. Every microcontroller must include this specification. Now, how the program memory can be operated? We know what is read-only memory. That means once the manufacturer has embed the instruction into it, it cannot be erased. It cannot be erased at all. So it is a fixed type instruction ROM. But how it can be programmed by the user, that's why there is a technology to use the memory like EEPROM, erasable programmable read-only memory, and EEPROM, electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. So EEPROM means UV EEPROM. That means the program code can be erased with the radiation of the ultraviolet, optical radiation, and it will be blank. Again, it can be programmed with a high voltage. But in case of a flash type or EEPROM, basically flash is an erasable before write. So EEPROM, that is electrically erasable method, can be used in place of flash type memory. Every time, that means the user can erase and rewrite the code many times within a very small small time. So erasing will occur within a, that means in terms of the few seconds. But in case of a EV type EEPROM, the it is required the high time, like 4 minutes or 2 minutes, to erase the complete code, stored code. So that's why nowadays every microcontroller uses EEPROM or flash type memory as a program memory, not the data memory. But data memory is not the EEPROM type. Data memory is S type, SRAM type, static RAM type. So these are the overall property characteristics of each unit of the microprocessor. So now we'll go to the move to the another, that means so many architecture, that is internal architecture and its characteristics, that means reset logic and the reset circuit and many more. Watchdog timer, that means what is mean by the watchdog timer, etc. So there are two types of the internal blocks. One for the reset logic, how the internal reset signal will be generated by the microcontroller itself. It has also the external reset in signal, and there is a watchdog timer. That means whenever the microprocessor is allowed to run, execute the program, then there is a separate timer which will be used for supervising the activity of the CPU. For example, if there is any program which has on the runtime, the program goes into the infinite loop, what will happen? In case of an ordinary microprocessor, there is no way, no need to come out until the microprocessor is powered off. But with the help of the watchdog timer, what will happen? After some time, if the microprocessor goes, it fails to come out from the loop, then what will happen? Ultimately, the watchdog timer will generate a reset signal, a power on reset signal, so the microprocessor will be automatically off. That means something is going wrong inside the microprocessor. So watchdog application, watchdog timer is a separate type of timer which is not accessible to the user, but it is only accessible to the CPU. That means it will supervise the activity of the CPU, whether the CPU comes into an infinite loop or any other things like divide by zero application in under runtime case. We'll discuss about this. What is the meaning of the watchdog? So I think today is enough for an introductory lecture. Now we will give details about the other things, programming methodology and other things. So whether now there is a question whether you are following, you are able to follow the concept of the microcontroller. What is the basic difference between the microprocessor and the microcontroller? So somebody are joining in a very late. I do not know whether that means there is a class. So you have missed so many things. It may not be clear to you only by going through the notes. So there are some concepts.
Sir, note ta ki mane ajke share kore deben.
Hello.
হ্যাঁ স্যার, বলছি যে নোটটা কি আজকেই শেয়ার করে দেবেন?
হ্যাঁ সে তো দিচ্ছি শেয়ার করে, কিন্তু প্রথম ক্লাসটা অনেক অনেক ডিলেট হয়েছে
মানে স্যার
কি বলবো।
রেকর্ড বোধহয় হচ্ছে, মানে রেকর্ডটা পরে দেখে নিলেও হবে, অনেকে
কোনটা
মিস করে
রেকর্ড
স্যার এই
চাই?
ক্লাসটার রেকর্ড। রেকর্ড
রেকর্ড তো এই ক্লাসে করিনি, এই পরের ক্লাস থেকে রেকর্ড করব, অফিসিয়াল জিমেইল ইউজ করব। এটা তো নোট দিয়ে দিতে পারি,
হ্যাঁ স্যার
ইন্ট্রোডাকশন
ঠিক আছে,
লেকচার, দ্যাট ইজ বেসিক ডিফারেন্স বিটুইন দা মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার অ্যান্ড মাইক্রো প্রসেসর অ্যান্ড আদার থিংস।
হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে
যাক
স্যার,
আমি তো এই ই নোটটা দিয়ে দেবো, আর এর পরের ক্লাস থেকে অ্যাকচুয়ালি A051 আর্কিটেকচারের উইল স্টার্ট এক্সপ্লেনিং দ্য A051 আর্কিটেকচার ইন ডিটেল অ্যান্ড ইটস প্রোগ্রামিং। দেয়ার আর টু পার্ট, দ্যাট মিন 8051 মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার আর্কিটেকচার অ্যান্ড ইটস প্রোগ্রামিং অ্যান্ড অলসো দ্য আর্কিটেকচার, নট অনলি দ্য 8051 বাট অলসো দ্য ইয়েস আর্কিটেকচার মিন দ্য আর্কিটেকচার অফ দ্য ওয়ার্কিং প্রিন্সিপাল অফ দ্য ইটস ইন পেরিফেরাল ইন্টারনাল পেরিফেরাল রিসোর্সেস অ্যান্ড দ্য প্রোগ্রামিং। দেন দ্যাট ইজ অ্যানাদার পার্ট, দ্যাট ইজ আর্কিটেকচার অফ দ্য এভিআর মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার হুইচ ইজ এ লিটল বিট অফ কমপ্লেক্স, বিকজ ওয়াই ইট ইজ ইম্পর্টেন্ট, বিকজ নাও এ ডে ইউ হ্যাভ হার্ড দ্যাট মিন্স দ্যাট ইজ এ মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার এম্বেডেড মডিউল লাইক অ্যাড্রিনো, সো অ্যাড্রিনো ইউজ এজ দ্য এভিআর টাইপ মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার। সো দেয়ার আর টু টাইপস অফ দ্য মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার হুইচ আর ইউজড, ওয়ান ইজ আর্ম মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার হুইচ আর বিং ইউজড ইন দ্য রাসবেরি পাই মডিউল হুইচ ইজ মাচ মোর পাওয়ারফুল, ইট ইজ অ্যাজ গুড অ্যাজ আ মাইক্রো কম্পিউটার, অ্যান্ড দ্যার ইজ অ্যানাদার দ্যাট মিন্স এম্বেডেড মডিউল দ্যাট ইজ অ্যাড্রিনো মডিউল। সো অ্যাড্রিনো ইনকর্পোরেশন হ্যাজ ইন্ট্রোডিউস অ্যাট লিস্ট 24 আর মোর দ্যান 24 মডিউল ইউনিট হুইচ আর সুটেবল ফর এম্বেডেড অ্যাপ্লিকেশন, ইন্টারনেট অফ থিংস অ্যান্ড মেনি মোর। সো দ্যাটস ওয়াই দ্য ওনলি দ্য নলেজ অফ এভিআর প্রোগ্রামিং, এভিআর মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোলার সিরিজ লাইক অ্যাটমেগা 8, অ্যাটমেগা 32, অ্যাটমেগা 16 দিস আর অ্যাটমেগা 6628P অ্যান্ড মেনি মোর, সো দিস বিলংস টু দ্য এভিআর আর্কিটেকচার। সো ইফ ইউ নট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্য থিওরি অফ দ্য 8051 মাইক্রো কন্ট্রোল আর্কিটেকচার ইন ডেপ, ইউ ক্যান নট ফলো দ্য আর্কিটেকচার অফ দ্য এভিআর, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য প্রবলেম। সো দ্যাটস ওয়াই ইউ মাস্ট লার্ন ইন ডিটেল অ্যাবাউট দ্য ইন্টারনাল আর্কিটেকচার অফ দ্য 8051 অ্যান্ড ইটস প্রোগ্রামিং। And also there is a basic feature that means here, in case of a 51 architect, in case of a 8051, you need to write the assembly language programming. Okay. But here, there is an added feature that means you can write the program, not only the assembly, but also the C. So the compilers are available so that it will follow the ANSI C standard code. So you can write the microcontroller program in town using the C, which is called the micro C. And it will automatically, the compiler will automatically transfer to the machine code.
Sir?
So that's why there is a feature that means nobody now uses the assembly
Sir?
Language program for microcontroller. Yes.
Sir, apnar presentation
is
visible. Sir, presentation is visible.
আমি জেনারেল ডিসকাস করছি আর কি, হোয়াট ইজ দ্যার সি, সেগুলো তো এখন আরম্ভ করেনি, সেগুলো হচ্ছে এর মধ্যে আছে সিলেবাস।
ওকে
তো টুডে আই স্টুডেন্ট অ্যান্ড দিস নোট আই উইল বি সেন্ডিং টু ইয়ার গ্রুপ মেল আইডি sometimes in with I will supply the shared link for class note which will be stored in the Google Drive also like that. So today there is a 1 hour class, so I will continue that is 1.5 hours, and this class will be I think a special class on Saturday. Generally the time slot for this class is on each Friday at 6:30, okay? Not today, so that is Saturday. That is, your class will be held in on every Friday at about 6:30. This is the allotted time slot. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in next week, we will I will take the class on Friday, not Saturday. Thank you for attending the class.
Okay. Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, আপনি ওই ওয়াটমিটারে যে ক্যালিব্রেশনের এক্সপেরিমেন্টটা করালেন ওখানে অবজারভেশন টেবিলটা আমি আপনি শেয়ার করেন ওটা একটু কাইন্ডলি শেয়ার করে দেবেন
ওই অবজারভেশন টেবিলটা তো প্রেজেন্টেশনের মধ্যেই আছে
স্যার প্রেজেন্টেশনটা আপনি মনে হয় দেননি একটুখানি একবার
ঠিক আছে করে দিয়েছি কিন্তু প্রেজেন্টেশনটা তো দিয়েছি কালকে আমি তো ভিডিওগ্রাফি দিয়েছি আর প্রেজেন্টেশন দিয়েছি প্রেজেন্টেশন পিপিটি দিইনি ঠিক আছে তাহলে দিয়ে দিচ্ছি আবার শেয়ার সেটা পাঠিয়ে দিচ্ছি ওটা তো শেয়ার দরকার নেই ওটা পাঠিয়ে দিচ্ছি ডাইরেক্ট যেখানে অবজারভেশন টেবিল আছে দুখানা টেবিল আছে টেবিল ওয়ান টেবিল টু
ওকে স্যার
ওকে